Hello, good evening everyone. I thank Prabhu and team at Meth Hospital and IMA Konumbak for giving me this opportunity to talk on evaluation of a case of allergy. So when we look at allergy, 25 to 30% of the population is allergic to something, and also people like fancifully say that they are allergic. So, but the problem is like many disorders can actually mimic allergic symptoms, and allergy can virtually affect any organ system. So when we look at an evaluation, what is required is we need to take a very comprehensive, a detailed medical history, a comprehensive physical examination, because sometimes like these allergic problems, when they present, at physical examination, you know, you may be able to pick it up because it's very evanescent. So that's why important physical examination is a very important part of your evaluation, and it is important to order appropriate diagnostic tests. So when we look at the history has to be comprehensive. So we actually spend an hour with the patient when we do an allergy evaluation. We have to look at the seasonality or diurnal variation of symptoms when we have patients with asthma, which becomes worse during pollination. Identification of triggers is very important, as we see in the case history that I'm going to present. And something which is always being overruled is this occupational exposure, because we see cases of asthma, but not we increase the steroid dose, we change inhalers, but we're not able to nail down the treatment because we've ruled out this occupational exposure. And that's why it's very important to have a material safety data sheet from the patient when he's working in industries. And a pertinent medical history is also a very important part of your evaluation. And in the history, we have to find out what are the major indoor allergens, which are important triggers and sensitizers, mostly in allergic asthma and rhinitis. And irritants, cigarette smoke, perfume, cold air, cleaning solvents. I had a case of a chronic cough. The patient had changed different consultants, but she was not able to get relief. And all her problem after the evaluation found out to be she was, you know, the husband was a smoker, and she was like, you know, getting this irritant cough, and that was the problem. And also had a case of asthma where this patient, only after evaluation, we found that, you know, it was because of the new perfume that he was using, his symptoms all started. So which is why it is very important to spend a considerable amount of time in history taking, which as consultants we generally don't do. And outdoor allergens, parthenium, again, that's a very common outdoor allergen here in our country, the Congress grass that we call it. And one thing about this outdoor allergens is when you become allergic to some pollens, there's something called priming where you get sensitized to multiple other allergens. And an occupational exposure, very important to get the material safety data sheets, because the material safety data sheets itself will be listed that some chemicals can cause, they are called as occupational allergens or occupational asthmatogens. So history is very important even in staging of your asthma treatment. A genetic component is very important because the risk is 75% if both the parents are atopic versus 50% if one parent is atopic. Quality of life survey is also very important to address the subjective parameters that contribute to your allergic severity. Confirmers of allergy, where you have like, you know, I see cases where the patient goes doctor hopping. They say like, you know, it's a cold that never goes off. So recurrent use of antibiotics, frequent colds, but the problem is not being recognized as due to allergy. And GERD, skin rash, pruritus, all of these are very important confounders of allergy. A drug history is also very important, and I see a lot of cases, you know, where because of the marketing, where you have a lot of these over-the-counter medication abuse and herbal supplements, which actually manifests urticaria. And important to take a history of use of ACE inhibitors in patients presenting with cough and beta blockers. Next. Yeah, so physical examination, so it's sometimes normal at the time of presentation, as allergic symptoms and signs are often evanescent, which means a lack of finding does not rule out allergy, And childhood asthmatics or long-term inhaled corticosteroids, we have to look at their growth percentiles and physical examination, look for markers of allergy like allergic shiners, conjunctival injection, cataracts in people on inhaled steroids, otoscopic examination for serous otitis media, most of our patients present with that, nasal mucosa, polyps, oral thrush in patients on inhalers, chest and skin examination. When we look at the armamentarium of testing, I told you we have to do relevant examinations testing so that your allergic skin testing is actually stands up when we want to detect allergy. And some other important people who cannot or who are afraid of skin testing, we can use the specific IgEs and the total IgE, spirometry, peak flow monitoring are all important in allergy testing. So conclusion, the treatment allergen avoidance is the most important management and followed by pharmacotherapy. And for patients who do not respond to allergen avoidance and pharmacotherapy, sublingual immunotherapy is a valid option. Okay? And asthma action plan is very important and education is also a very important integral part of care. So when we look at a case study of a management of a case of allergy, a 38-year-old lady referred by an ENT consultant for management of persistent rhinitis. She walked into my clinic and she complained of running nose, watery eyes, itching of throat and palate, fullness of the ears for most days of the year. She also complained of headaches, sleepiness, increased fatigue for the past 6 months. Also gives a history of cough, which is of recent onset. On examination, a tired-looking middle-aged lady, a medium build, no pallor, had allergy faces because of the congestion, denim organ lines. Congestion of both eyes was present, no obvious discharge. The nasal septum, she had a mild deviation. Mucosa was pale and edematous, no facial edema, no enlarged nodes. Vital signs was normal. Respiratory system, I was able to pick up a few bronchi. No significant past medical history. Investigations like the CT scan sinuses was already done by the ENT surgeon, was normal. She was on antihistamines, antileukotrienes, and steroid nasal spray. So how I managed this case? I told you a very comprehensive history on the onset, timing, duration, seasonality, severity, associated symptoms, the aggravating and elevating factors, a thorough environmental history, a family history of atopy, and a history of what are the suspected allergens, history of nasal trauma. And actually when I did that history, I followed like she was indoors, her symptoms were bad, but she was better when she was away from home. She complained of allergy to most of the dust in the house. Also gives a history of frequent change of pets. So her diagnosis was allergic rhinitis. There is a classification called ARIA classification, which is allergic rhinitis and its impact on asthma. So she was in the severe and persistent category. And she also had features of asthma because I did a spirometry and it was obstructive findings. So then when we go to allergic rhinitis, it's very important before we do any allergy skin testing or any investigations to rule out non-allergic causes. So these are the important differentials for allergic rhinitis, whether it was infectious, drug-induced, hormonally induced. You have to rule out, you know, whether she has any hypothyroidism, exercise, whether it was structural or mechanical factors, septal deviation, turbinate hypertrophy, or whether there were any immunological disease present. Next. So the differential, again, it is important to take a good history of any OCPUs, NSAIDs, AC inhibitors. So these are some of the drugs which can cause rhinitis. And the differential diagnosis for asthma was like whether it was due to postnatal drip or GERD is very important to be ruled out. So the symptoms are like itching, rhinorrhea, congestion, edema, and repetitive symptoms are sneezing, watery rhinorrhea, pruritus, congestion, eye symptoms. So one thing interesting is when we see cases of allergy, they do not have allergy symptoms that is pertaining to one organ system. It actually presents with a lot of other symptoms. They complain of eye symptoms, ear symptoms, postnatal discharge because of all the histamine release. So also, it's very important to take a quality of life And most of allergic patients experience weakness, discomfort, irritability, fatigue, decrease in appetite and difficulty in concentrating. And this would be aggravated more with the antihistamines which they are already on. And also produces dry, irritated sore throat, snoring, pain around the eyes, mouth breathing, orthodontic disturbances, frontal headaches and chronic cough. So this was the ARIA classification which I was talking about, allergic rhinitis and its impact on asthma, whether the symptoms are intermittent or persistent. So when it is like less than 4 days a week or less than four weeks and it is mild, which means there is normal sleep, no impairment of daily activities, normal work in school and no troublesome symptoms. When it is more than 4 times a week and it is for more than 4 weeks, it's persistent, and that will involve abnormal sleep, impairment of daily activities, abnormal school and work, and troublesome symptoms. And very important to recognize, because there is always this dichotomy between the upper airways and the lower airways, but presently the current evidence states that an inflammatory process which is present anywhere, it influences. So that is why if you see here the case of allergic rhinitis, she also had asthmatic symptoms. Go next. So this is the comorbidities and implication of treatment. Allergic rhinitis and asthma are linked in epidemiological, pathophysiological and clinical studies. It's very important to recognize that rhinitis may be an independent risk factor for asthma. 80% of children with asthma have allergic disease. Allergic rhinitis and otitis media also link allergic rhinitis and sinusitis. So treatment of allergic rhinitis may be important for its own sake and for its impact on other upper and lower airway diseases. Also interesting is treatment of allergic rhinitis with steroid nasal spray improves even the lung function. So when I did the skin testing, I gave the choice to the patient whether she wanted to do a allergy skin testing or the in vitro testing, where we look at the blood specific IgEs. And the advantages of skin testing is it is cheaper. I recharge 600 rupees, but whereas the labs which we do these in vitro testing for the allergens, specifically for each specific IgE, it costs around 300 rupees. So this is how I did the skin testing. The goal is to identify antigens to which the patients are symptomatically reactive, to quantify the sensitivity if immunotherapy is warranted in these cases. So what we call it is the skin prick testing, or it's a skin superficial reaction, you know. So that's why it's not the intradermal test of those days, which is highly specific, sensitive, and there is no fear of anaphylaxis, convenient and safe, requires a positive histamine and a negative saline control. A droplet of antigen is introduced about 1 millimeter deep into the skin. The only disadvantage is there is an inter-tester variability, and sometimes like some allergen extracts are not standardized, which is why we have to purchase these extracts from standardized labs. So this, based on the history, I picked up, because she said her symptoms were more indoors, I picked up the dust mites, the fungi, the Aspergillus fumigatus and Niger, which is very common in our population. Next. Then because she didn't have any symptoms outstairs, I didn't pick any of the pollens. Next. The dust, again the house dust is also available. And she also gave a history of frequent change of pets. So the epithelia of the pets are also tested. Next. So she complained of dots. So that's where the son of that lady was very fond of, you know, different breeds of dogs. So that's why I checked the dog epithelia. The insect, because cockroach is very common in our infestation in the house, I picked up the cockroach antigen. And the food, she complained of allergy to lemon.